I definitely wouldn't call John Wick an angel, but he's definitely not a villain. He's the hero of his franchise, ridding the world of its endless supply of trained assassins one bullet at a time. But what if John Wick was actually the bad guy? Could anyone stand a chance? The only thing keeping the world from being thrown into absolute chaos is knowing that John Wick is a good guy. If it was the other way around and he was actually pure evil, I'm sure you'd see mass panic, eternal darkness, and cats and dogs raining from the sky. Oh no. Dogs raining from the sky? That's only gonna make John more mad. Let's look at an alternate reality where John Wick was actually the bad guy. What hero could rise up and stop him? Let's get into it. So why would John Wick turn fully to the dark side? Well, in this alternate reality, it all has to do with one person, Helen. In the original timeline, John met Helen when he was working for Vigo in his crime organization. They apparently met in a restaurant and just immediately hit it off. After falling in love with Helen, John completes an impossible task for Vigo that allows him to retire peacefully. Of course, that's cut short after only 5 years when Helen gets a terminal illness, and then there's that whole thing with a puppy, you know the story. But let's say things happened a bit differently. Now, in this alternate reality, John meets Helen and wants to retire. He still completes the impossible task for Vigo because John will always complete any mission assigned to him, but this time, Helen finds out about it. She learns the man she loves is actually the world's greatest hitman, and that understandably makes her a little hesitant. The fact that he's a trained killer working for the mob has Helen evaluate her options. This breaks John's heart, so he does what he does best and continues to work as an assassin for Vigo. But now there's a loose end. Since Helen knows who and what John is, Vigo can't have her alive and has Helen executed. This sets off a series of chain results. John wipes out Vigo and his operation for killing Helen, catches the attention of the High Table, who wants John dealt with, forcing John to fight back, where he continues to rise higher and higher. So now, there's the problem. An evil John Wick now runs the High Table. So the ramifications of an evil John Wick running the High Table are epic. A rebellion would take place in the assassin underworld. This causes one man to form his own super team of assassins, Winston. That's right, the owner of the New York Continental knows that evil John Wick needs to be stopped. Through his connections, he brings together a group of highly trained assassins. I imagine an all-out war against evil John Wick. It most likely takes place in some neon warehouse or something like that. Here's how I see it play out. Marcus would cover the team with a sniper, and Sophia, along with her two dogs, would lead the ground team of Zero, Cassian, and Ares. Sorry, Marcus, you should have never split from the pack. Evil John Wick would know all of his old mentor's tricks and have rigged his sniper perch with explosives. Bye-bye, Marcus. Without sniper cover, Evil John is free to move around like the boogeyman he truly is. He's able to draw Zero away by preying on Zero's admiration for John and the assassin's desire to kill John himself. Things go poorly for the rest of them, as you would probably expect. Long story short, the only survivors are Sophia's dogs, which John is able to turn to his side. Oh great, now evil John Wick has two dogs. With his attempts to kill John in a logical way failed, this is gonna force Winston to get creative. He has one last Hail Mary, so hold on to your butts. Winston will realize there's only one person who could possibly stop evil John Wick, and that's John Wick himself. That's right, I'm bringing time travel to the John Wick franchise, because why not? Hey, if the Fast and Furious franchise can evolve from stealing VCRs to a probable space adventure, then the John Wick franchise can go sci-fi. So Winston goes all Terminator and plucks John Wick from our universe and brings him over. Now we have a John Wick versus evil John Wick fight. Each one knows each other's moves and strategies, so one can't really gain the upper hand on the other. The real key is Sophia's dogs. Evil John Wick tries to sic them on good John Wick, but the good John Wick is able to take control of them. He's a much better dog person after all. And evil John Wick would kill a lot of people, but would hesitate slightly in killing the animals, and that would prove to be fatal. In the end, it'd be kind of ironic. The evil John Wick would be killed by the one animal that started our John's initial rampage. That's nice symmetry, right? With order restored, John asks Winston if he's ever seen Avengers Endgame, and asks to go to a universe where Helen is still alive and they can share a dance together or some other romantic moment. Everybody wins. Alright, is this a little silly? Absolutely. But seriously, how else do you expect to beat an evil John Wick? What do you think would happen if John Wick was pure evil? Could anyone stop him? Let us know in the comments below and be sure to hit that like and subscribe button for more awesome John Wick content like this. Thanks for watching CBR. See you next time.